What is up, everybody? How are you guys doing today? So, want to thank everybody who viewed my last video. Putting out these songs videos are extremely tough because they copyright the crap out of them so fast. You have to, like I said, and I always say, I hate having to talk for so long just to get one pass through. For example, the most recent video that I put up about music, the very last song that I put up on this video, the last video, very last song, is the one that had the copy strike. So it would do partially blocked. Last time I had a partially blocked, it's list, the countries, but then in the algorithm of YouTube, where it shows where people are watching your videos and all this stuff, none of those countries show up on my, people who view my videos. But then I only get like one view on a partially blocked video. Where my videos will average at least a few, like 10, maybe, some video, like I said, my whole setup here, I haven't quite found the little recipe yet. I was shocked that the Newfound Glory video has as much video, as much, how many views that it, God, I can't even fucking talk today. How many views it's gotten over, what, 500? Because I've played Newfound Glory before, not a lot of people showed any interest, but, kind of playing them side by side so you could see just how great the dude's voice is. That like really that shocked me. I was like, wow, I love Newfound Glory. So anyways, I tried to attempt to make this video last week, and I'm gonna attempt it again. I'm gonna use some of the coolest songs to me personally that I like, and what movie they were used in, and if the scene was good or bad. So let's see how this works out. All right, so here we go. For song number one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to what's been working and use this right here, because this seems to work the best when I just, I'm sorry I have to show my ugly mug here, but I'm afraid to even use a black backdrop. They've been seeming to go through when I use this method, so let's see if this will work. But you did see the song that I just pulled up. I'll at least put that there. Van Halen. Love Van Halen. Love this song. Let me know if you think that it was used well in the movie. So here we go. So part of my whole little way of getting some of these videos passed is pausing, talking, and then saying something about the song that I found. There's a little hidden gem in here that I know they wouldn't have had him sing twice over it. You couldn't possibly replicate it twice. As I mentioned before, having sat in on, studio sessions other than, bands like, the people playing the guitar, the bass, the drums, so on and so forth. They've all been pretty much R&B or hip hop, so everything's already kind of set in place. All you have is the artist in the booth doing either the rapping or the singing. Whereas this case, they'll probably have already recorded everything else, and then the singer, they'll be playing through the headphones. The singer will then start singing. So then, the beats and all that, from my understanding, is that those are already made. Singer comes in, does his thing. But if you notice at 29 seconds, and as I've explained this before, when you're looking at the mixing and mastering of anything, you're seeing on the screen, the decibels that, the individual is reaching. And then once they get like a good enough take, then, they'll want to replicate it almost identical. So that's why you get such like a reverb that is very, very, very subtle. But as I mentioned, if you've ever listened through a pair of, $5,000 headphones, like real studio headphones, you can tell it, there is like the best way to describe it is the old Japanese movies of King Kong, when you see them speaking and you see the English, they're speaking English when in fact they're actually speaking Japanese, but it's off. Now, imagine that being off by only a fraction of a fraction of a second. You just hear a little bit of a reverb. And that's what makes them sound so great. But there's no way he could have possibly have done this in my mind, because when he hits the highest pitch at about 28, 29, have you seen her moving with the style and ease? And then from across the room, after he says from across the room, when he goes really high, he laughs. And to me, that's subtle, might be stupid to some people, but I'm like, that's cool. He's having fun doing what he loves. And that's how I feel about doing, acting or whatever else I may be doing that I love doing. Laughing, having fun doing it. And you could tell at that part he's having fun and probably proud of himself too. He hits this extremely high note beautifully, and he does a quick little giggle, which I'm sure they cut right there, and then they kept that, It's perfect. So if you listen at about like 29 seconds, it's very quick, but you could hear him giggle. And I feel like from across the room, it's love in the... See, I don't know if people caught it. I'm sure you can after me explaining, but from across the room, then he kind of does a quick giggle. It's just funny to me that he was having fun doing this. Oops, shit, wrong button. So there's not a great copy, unfortunately, but let's see the highest setting this will go, 480p. But I still think it was the best use of this song in any movie. Connie Nielsen, Gladiator, great actress. You know what makes me so jealous? Because you see some of these actors, actresses, they're so talented. They could sing, they can dance. I've said it many times before. I can't sing, I can't dance. I have nothing to act out in front of you guys. So, other than when the trailer drops or the movie drops, the first one, which will be the soonest, the first movie I did obviously will be out sooner than the second one I did. Obviously, then, I'll show it. But yeah, she just, damn it, she's talented. And if you've ever seen this movie, this is, as I would describe, like a real cute moment. And I don't want to give any spoiler alerts away, but you have Connie Nielsen, you have Gary Sinise, you have Don Cheadle. I know it's Connell or O'Connell, is it? God, he's been in so many movies. I forget his name, but good actor. I always liked him. But yeah, what happens next is something else. But it's just like a cute moment in the movie. Perfect use for the song. Course, Timothy Roth. Shawshank Redemption. Dude's awesome. When I had heard this song used in that section of the movie, I thought, what a perfect combination there, at least in my opinion. So I'll go on to a second one and see if I can find another great song used just brilliantly in a movie, which there's tons of them, by the way. All right, so top 20 band, one of my faves. Love this song. About maybe 2 years ago, was jamming it out nonstop all summer. I don't know why. I get in one of those moods, you know, you get into this rhythm of listening to certain genres for a year. At least I do. And then I'm just like jamming out all these old school songs, or, you know, if I hear something cool that's more modern, which I haven't heard in a while, then I'll be jamming out to that. But love this band. They're looking at the camera. Don't look at the camera.
The faster we're falling, we're stopping and stalling. We're running in circles again. Just as things were looking up, you said it wasn't good enough. But still, we're trying one more.
You know, I gotta say, I never quite understood that because I myself was a jock. I played football and basketball, and I never understood, and I always felt uncomfortable when somebody did the ass slapping. It's like, dude, just, that's it. That's what I would do. But like the whole jock, like, I don't know where that came from. Where'd it come from? The origins. Oh, quick fact. I forgot about this. He was married to Avril Lavigne for like 4 or 5 years or something like that. And I think once she married him, she kind of like stopped doing her music. And then she married the guy from Nickelback, the lead singer. From what I remember, I only know that because I was watching how different generations reacted to, you know, different generations of music. And then they had put that little known fact about him and her that they lasted for 4 years. But I'm going to fast forward to a funny part just because this will definitely help not get the video blocked. It's a great song, though.
I saw foreshadowing, and then I also seen something else that I noticed for the first time in this. So that guitar right there, that's a Les Paul Gibson, a sunburst one, and I had looked it in there before.
So let's see here. This is crazy. $22,000 for a 1994, I believe. It's one off the rack if I wanted to go to Guitar Center right now. Gibson Les Paul Standard 50 Electric Guitar Heritage Cherry Sunburst, $2,990. So I totally blocked it yesterday when I was talking about the fretboard and all that stuff. But for those of you guys who don't know, you see these things right here. These are the frets. So the different frets that you would hit. I was talking about it on the last video I made and my big ass mug was covering it. So my bad on that. But yeah, beautiful ass guitar. So there's no way that they used a real one in that. There's a couple of things that I had noticed when I had first watched it. I had recorded this before. And then I thought, oh crap, I think I let it play too long, so I'm re-recording it. So my statements that I'm using now were on the first record. So you can see the guard. I forgot what it's called, the literal term for it. But you can see the guard and then also right here. And on here, it's completely gone. No guard. No nothing. It kind of looks like maybe there might be a little one, but yeah, there's no way in hell they're going to use a real one coming out of the swimming pool like that, because that's just going to ruin the shit out of that guitar, because that guitar has awesome picks. So that's why he's able to play it like that. If he wanted to, and just you plug that sucker in, and if you want to play it like that, just as long as you're not holding down on the, you know, further down on the fretboard, you could easily play it like that with those pickups. And the foreshadowing part was his buddy looking down, almost like if he's looking on a cell phone or something. He could be doing that or looking at his nails. I think he's looking at his nails. But that's how everybody is nowadays. Like I was saying earlier, we're always... So, what movie they used it in? Here we go. Now, I cannot do anything about the quality because this was probably the best quality that I seen out of any of them. But this is where they use this. It's one thing to complain, but when they're driving me insane, well then I think it's time that we took a break. Cause I'm in too deep and I'm trying to keep up a bomb in my head instead of going under. Cause I'm in too deep and I'm trying to keep up a bomb in my head instead of going under. Instead of going under. Instead of going under. Instead of going under. The DEFCON said lie. This had to be part... Is it part two? Because I thought they were at a beach house. I don't know. I don't even remember anymore. But, yeah. Good use of a song. I love that movie. I know probably people nowadays, the way there's so many... everything's offensive nowadays. Too many people, like, not of our generation, be like... That was so inappropriate, and I can't believe they did that, and I'm so offended. You know, I can't get on board with things like that, man. Like, if something's offensive, like, I just keep it to myself, unless there's, like, children around. Then I'll be like, hey, come on, man. But, I mean, yeah. Good movie, funny movie, lines that will probably last a lifetime, just like a lot of other movies. But, I mean, it was part of my youth. That's what I remember. So, I think they used that song in this movie. Was good use to it, in my opinion. So, let's try another one, shall we? On to the last one. So, I grew up knowing everything about Metallica that you possibly can, because my brother was, like, super fan. And I mean, they're iconic regardless. I mean, they're fucking, they're awesome. Got to go see them in concert. Funny story about this. Let me tell this story right now. Well, you know what? I'll save it for partway through because Lars Ulrich will probably come out and kick, you know, maybe try to kick my ass because he hates, like, when they uploaded, you know, Metallica songs from Napster days. I know younger crowds won't understand what Napster is, but you basically got a free virus. Maybe a song out of it, but it was peer-to-peer sharing. Yeah, we were stupid about computers back then. Anyways, great song. Like I said, super fan. He caught, in multiple concerts, a drumstick and a pick. And so, yeah, he's just had like every documentary about them. You know, their first bassist died. Second bassist was awesome. And then he just like gave up. He just retired. Since then, I think he stopped like listening to them like after, gosh, I can't even remember around the time. He just kind of like, you know, just it wasn't the same Metallica. Like, some people always say, like, oh, they were better when they were doing drugs and alcohol. It's neither here nor there, but I'll tell you the funny story just so I could get this video passed through. So, here we go. Here's a song. You ever heard the word? Okay, story time, just to get the video passed through. So, it was Kid Rock, Korn, and Metallica headlining. Invesco Field at Mile High, that's what it was called at the time. But you're from Denver when you just call it Mile High Stadium. I don't care who the hell's sponsoring it. It was always Mile High Stadium before, it's Mile High Stadium now. It was fairly new, I think it was like maybe only a few years old. And Metallica is always going to have freaking huge crowds. I mean, they're going to pack out a stadium. You're not going to have this at the time, which was a Pepsi Center. Now it's Ball Stadium or Ball Arena. Used to be the Pepsi Center. Anyways, they have a lot to do with drinks. Pepsi Center, then Coors Field. Yeah. Anyways. So I'm 6'4". My best friend's dad at the time, my guy best friend, because I always talk about my two best friends, guy and a girl. My guy best friend, his dad was like really, 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 really high up there in the police department. Like really high. And he got tickets because, you know, a lot of them will do like off work security and stuff like that. And he got tickets to the concerts for us. And we had like the ground level and all that stuff. And so we're walking, we're making our way. I'm 6'4", and I started, like, losing some weight at this time. So I'm probably, like, around 280-ish or so. I hadn't reached nowhere near my goal. Maybe, let me be a little bit lighter. Maybe 270, 260, 270, somewhere around there. My brother's about 6'7", 6'8", you know, about 300. Back then, probably, like, 300 pounds, 310, somewhere around there. And we're making our way through the crowd, and my former best friend, he's like 6'1", about 200 pounds. Not fat or chubby at all, you know. Mostly just, you know, not built, but just, you know, solid. He was an athlete as well. So we're all making our way through the crowd, and all of a sudden, we just feel this, somebody from behind, and this guy's like, hey, he's like, do you guys think you could throw me? He asked my brother and I that, so we're like, okay, so we pick this little dude up. And I even think that when we threw him, he was like doing this shit in the air because he was like freaked out. Like, it was fucking hilarious. Great concert, though. We try to avoid the whole mosh pit thing because once that started, when Korn was on, it was like, oh shit, let's move off to the side. So we move off to the side, and then Metallica comes on, and by then we like kind of moved our way towards like the front row seats. We were sitting down more or less. This is what a badass Kirk Hammett is, and Kirk Hammett is the lead guitarist. You know, James Hetfield is the lead singer, and he plays guitar too, but Kirk Hammett, you know, he's your lead guitarist. He's just jamming out, walking backwards, tripped on some chords, fell down, and he was still jamming it. And it's like he didn't miss a beat. And you know this shit is live. Like, they're not, you know, just faking it. I mean, you could tell because strums an accidental chord, but he's still jamming it. Gets up and just starts doing, like, whole crowd goes wild, man. Awesome, awesome moment. They're a great, great band. So, and play a little bit more. If you guys don't know what the song is about, it's called Master of Puppets. Go look it up. It's really, it's a crazy song. Obey your master! Master! Master of Puppets, I'm pulling your strings! Twisting your mind and smashing your dreams! Dying by me, you can't see a thing! Just call my name, cause all you scream! The movie. Now this to me has to be the best use of music in a movie. I was gonna say music video in a movie. Here we go.
Yes. Here's the deal, listen up! All together we pick 14 pledges.
Wait, who's this guy?
Well, that's Blue.
Yeah.
It's an old Navy vet who hangs around my store a lot. But don't worry about it, he's legit.
He looks like he's 100 years old, he wants to pledge.
Are you kidding me? The old man River won't shut up about it.
Go time!
Again, just to get it passed through without it, you know, getting partially blocked or copyright crap, I have to do this, so I have to fill up some story time here. When, before I ever had an inkling of really following through with, so I went to acting classes because, like, my buddy talked me into it, like, oh, you should come with me, you know, this and that. Something to do. It was, you know, no sports going on. It was, you know, winter. So, yeah, just get out of the house. Something to do. And this is before, like, you know, my partying days. I was a sophomore in high school, and this is when I was going to private school. So, you know, I hadn't met my my other friends that like to drink and all that stuff. So, wasn't drinking, partying at this time. So, I go to the acting classes, and it was just something fun. So, without ever having an inkling of, you know, ever wanting to try or actually ending up being in a feature-length film, a couple years later, after the acting classes, I go to another school, and I remember a group of us, we're all drunk, we're sitting there, and, you know, we're writing, like, a movie script, like, or a story for, like, what a good story would be for, like, you know, to kind of highlight our days. Because we have a very, very, I mean, I think everybody could say, you know, their 4 years in high school and all that is unique. And ours was very unique. Everything from someone dying, that was very, very, very close with us. I'm not going to get into that part too much. But no, like, it could have been a lot of, like, you know, really good storylines and stuff like that. This was also around the time of Columbine. like that shit wasn't prevalent like it is now, constantly going on. And you know, we're like maybe 10 miles away from Columbine, and a lot of the times we're going to different house parties, Columbine kids were there, we're there. I mean, you know, we're in the same school district basically, so we're sitting downstairs though writing, you know, this opening scene to this movie and how it was going to start off. We used to have this thing where we'd get in the back of the truck, and let's just say it was very stupid. We were tackling objects that shouldn't be tackled. Let's just say that. Like almost like a trying to be like Superman, I guess. When you're drunk, you do stupid shit. So anyways, the opening scene was similar to this, except we were running, and there's a great song by Blink-182 on one of their very first few albums. It's called Cheshire Cat. That's the name of the album. And it's almost fitting to how this style is. Just that fast pace, you know. And to this day, like, I tell myself, like, if I ever make it far enough in the movie industry, I'm going to get that damn thing produced, because I just want to see that come to life. So hopefully my little bit of talking right now filled it up so we could watch the rest of the scene.
Anyone about this, I'll fucking kill you. I'm kidding. We'll come back by tonight. Okay, sweetie. Oh,
nice and easy. There we go.
There's tons more I could probably go through. Uh-oh. I love this song. It's a very personal song to me. They gave me a shout-out, by the way. I think I mentioned that about 1,000 times on my other videos. Anyways, yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. There's tons of movies that have great soundtracks to it. I try to put Guardians of the Galaxy with Redbone. Come Get Your Love. Yeah. Didn't go through quite well. So, I procrastinated on making this video. But, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Love. Man, I need to go back and watch Old School. Such a good movie. But anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope you're having a fun, enjoyable weekend. Have a great Memorial Day weekend. I'll probably be back before then with another video. I'm loving these music videos because it just brings back some good memories. I gotta do some more, you know you guys never seem to be really interested that much, at least the people that I have on here, in the paranormal type of stuff. And I have a few videos on the paranormal, which I had one person write me like, yeah, definitely tell the story. So, you know, if you guys are ever interested in anything else, please, by all means, let me know. Because not only do I like to create my own stuff like these kind of, you know, which decade did it best? Who do you like more? You know, awesome songs and movies. You know, I like to react to, you know, like that chapter and other content creators. So, yeah, hit me up, comment, let me know what you like, and yeah, we'll do our thing. Thank you very much for watching. And if you feel inclined to, like the video, subscribe to my channel, and, you know, comment. Good, bad, indifferent, whatever, just appropriate. So, anyways, you guys have a good one, and I'll be back soon. Peace.